Hello everyone, welcome to Green Learner. So this is the next video in the series about annotations in Java. We are learning core Java topic wise. First video we have covered all the questions. In this video we are going to cover all these three topics: what, why, how, built-in annotation and meta annotation. So without wasting any time, let's go ahead and get started. So what is this annotation? Annotations are metadata. What do I mean by metadata? They are additional information about a method, a field, a class type. Wherever you use annotations, they are some additional, they are telling some additional information whoever is going to use those. And so in this case, compiler is going to use that. So JVM is going to use those classes, methods, variables. So they provide additional information, metadata. They are alternative option for XML and marker interfaces. There are number of libraries based on Java which use XML, which were using XML. There was no option to pass the additional information. There were some things, right? So annotations were introduced kind of optional to XML. So you can use, if you do not want to use XML, instead of that you can use annotations also. It will make you stick to the Java only, right? So you can save yourself from XML. And they are also alternative to the marker interfaces. Marker interfaces, you know, the interfaces that don't have any methods, they are just signaled to JVM to do something extra, something specific about those classes which are implementing those interfaces. Like serializable is a marker interface, right? Annotations are there since JDK 5. They are not from the birth of the JDK, that is JDK 1, but they are introduced from JDK 5, 1.5. There are some predefined built-in annotations, so let's go ahead and check that out. There are standard annotations, that is override, suppress, warnings, deprecated. These are there since 1.5, Java 1.5. Safebear arcs were introduced in Java 7 and functional interface annotation was used in Java 8, right? And next, there is next category, which is meta annotations. They are under java.lang annotation package, and these annotations are under java.lang. So just for information, that do they belong. So they are retention, documented, target, inherited, repeatable and native. These two introduced are in Java 8. So you know, name of the annotation is start with @, right? So this is the main point. So as you see, classes, you create interfaces, there are some rules, right? With annotations, if any name is starting with @, you will know that these are annotations, right? So what is the difference between standard and meta annotations? So meta annotations are used to create other annotations, and they are standard annotations which are used in real life while you are doing the programming, right? So with the application development. So in this video, I'm going to explain you about the uses of these three annotations: override, suppress warning and deprecated. So this is the program that I already have written. So this is annotation in Java demo class that is there. So I am creating an object. I am printing this object, and when I print this object, I have written this toString method which belongs to object method, which belongs here, object class that is there. So when I print this one, it will be printed, right? And here ArrayList, I am creating one and adding the few things right here and printing this one. And this, there is one method right here. So this is about the program. Now coming to annotation, so see what the problems here. When I see yellow markers, there are some warnings coming right here, right? So if I come here, it is showing me the warnings. So how can I suppress these warnings? So suppress annotation is there for this, right? So now see, all the warnings are gone and now our program is clean, right? No problems found and nothing is coming here, right? So if it was not there, there were many warnings, but now these warnings are ignored by the compiler. So when to use and when not to use, so it depends on the situation. So suppress warnings is dangerous in many situations, right? There can be some many important warnings that you can ignore by this. So use these annotations carefully. Next annotation, coming to next annotation, is the override annotations, right? So override annotations indicates that you are overriding some methods that belongs to a parent class. In our case, it is a two string which belongs to the parent class object, right? So, but if we are human, when we are programming, there are chances of error, spelling mistake and all this, right? So suppose I do a mistake here, and by mistake I print this, I added one e, and I'm expecting that it is two string, but there is an error. So how do the, so when I run this program, it is not going to the way that I expected, right? When I print this, it should print this, but now it will not print because it is not the two string method right? So how can I avoid this this spelling mistake and all this? So when I know that I'm overriding this one, so I can use this annotation override. So it will make sure that it will throw you a compilation error, right? So if you are not overriding, so if you come here, it will say that method does not override method from its superclass. So you will know that there's some problem in the method that you are writing. So you remove this and it will work properly now. So now it will say that you're overriding something from the parent class. Now if I run the program, we have the way as I expected, right? Yeah, it is working. So now the third annotation, that is deprecated annotation. So when you are building a library and you have shipped it to a client, and in future releases you want to remove some method, some class, some interface from that, so how do you inform to the client? You cannot go ahead directly and remove that method or class or interface from there. You have to inform that. So deprecated annotation is for that only. So for example, I want to remove this test method from the future releases of the library, right? And I want to inform this. So how can I do that? So if I mark this annotation deprecated, so it will do the job for me, right? So if I go ahead and use this now test method, now it is cross line is coming here, right? So that mark line is coming here. It is saying that do not use this because it will be removed in the future releases. So deprecate annotation is for that, right? So this way, it is when you use this, it is not going to create any problem. So whatever is written inside that is going to work properly. But it is a warning that you do not use it in future releases, it will be removed. So this is it about the suppress warning, override, and deprecated annotation. Functional interface annotation, we will see this in detail when we are covering the functional interface, that is Lambda and Java 8 features, right? And meta annotations are those which help in creating other annotations. So we will create the custom annotation and process annotation in the next video, then we will cover this in detail, right? So coming to next topic, that is annotation types. So we have marker annotation, single value annotations, and multi value annotations. So marker annotations are there which do not take any value. That we see deprecated annotation is one kind of marker annotation. Single value, which take only one value, that we see suppress warning, which was taking one value, right? Multi value annotation, full annotations which take more than one value. I'll see in the next video when we will create the custom annotation and all those things. Right. So take care. Bye bye.